Hello viewers, welcome you all to my channel Know Your Eyes. Today I'm going to discuss about the Vergence facility. Now, just like accommodative facility, Vergence facility is yet another important parameter to examine during the orthoptic evaluation. Now, we know that whenever we are looking at a near target, our eyes converge because the bitemporal retinal image disparity takes place, which can be overcome by the positive fusional vergence or convergence, because that stimulates the corresponding retinal points, which helps us to retain the binocular single vision at near. We can get a single visual perception of that object at near because of convergence. Similarly, when we are looking at distance, that time the binasal retinal image disparity takes place, which is again overcome by the negative fusional vergence or divergence, and that's how the binocular single vision for distance is retained. So this change in the fusional vergence response according to the change in the vergence demands over a period of time is called the vergence facility. Now, there are some of the very basic and important points regarding Vergence facility to remember. Like, first of all, why should the Vergence facility be tested? It helps us to assess the presence of any Vergence anomalies in the patient, like basic exophoria or convergence excess or convergence insufficiency or any fusional Vergence dysfunction. So in these kinds of anomalies, the Vergence facility reading comes abnormal. Okay, now what happens in basic exophoria? In basic exophoria, the amount of exophoria is same for both distance and near. In convergence excess, the amount of esophoria is more at near than distance. In convergence insufficiency, the patient is more exophoric in near than distance. And in fusional vergence dysfunction, there is anomalies found in both the divergence and the convergence of the patient. So therefore, it is very important to perform the Vergence facility test, other than the many other parameters which are there in the field of Vergence to be evaluated during orthoptic evaluation, like amplitude of Vergence, the near point of convergence, etc. Vergence facility also forms a very, very important parameter to confirm the presence of any Vergence anomalies in the patient. Now, Vergence facility is tested with a tool called Vergence Flippers, which comes with a prism combination of a pair of base in prisms on one side and a pair of base out prisms on the other side. Because base in prism induces divergence in the patient and base out prism induces the positive fusional vergence or the convergence in the patient. Now, there are various prism combinations available, but the most commonly available Vergence Flipper comes with a combination of three prism diopter base seen on one side and a pair of 12 prism diopter base out on the other side. Other than the Vergence Flipper, we also require a visual target and a stopwatch, and the reading is measured in cycles per minute. The normative value has been found to be, for all the patients, has been found to be 12, with a difference of 2 plus minus 2 cycles per minute. So how to perform this test? The patient will be given a Snellen's 20/30 visual target, and he or she should be wearing his best visual correction. That means we have to record the best Snellen's acuity in each eye. And the target has to be held at 40 centimeter from the patient. Now the Vergence Flipper with that 3 prism base in and 12 base out prism combination will be alternately placed before the patient's eyes. And the patient will be asked to focus the target through a particular prism and make it single and clear. So the patient has to report when the object turns out to be absolutely clear and single through a particular prism. Say the patient is focusing through 12 base out prism. So the patient has to report when the object is absolutely looking clear and single through that 12 prism diopter base out. Once it is clear, the patient can flip and then see again through the 3 prism diopter base in. And the same thing will be repeated. The patient will again have to make the object clear and single through that 3 prism diopter base in. And then again the patient will flip and see through the base out. So like this, the cycle will get repeated for a minute. Okay, so when the patient looks through the base out, makes the object clear, and then again sees through the base in and makes the object clear, that completes one cycle. So this cycle gets repeated for a minute, and the number of successful flips is recorded in cycles per minute. Now, other than recording the number of cycles, we also have to record that with which particular prism the patient is taking a little longer time to fuse the object and make it single and clear. So that is important. Other than that, it also helps us to assess the presence of any suppression also in the patient, because if there is any suppression, any amblyopia in the patient, then either there will be a lateral movement of the eye or no movement of the eye at all. So this is also another very important parameter that we can get from this Vergence facility testing. So hope this video helps you in getting a clear concept about Vergence facility. If you have any queries, then please come up with that in the comment section. I'll revert to you as early as possible. And if you like this video, then please do like, share and subscribe. See you again in my next video. Till then, take care.